Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Honorable presiding member, in the committee state debate relating to these ministries, time had been inordinately occupied for other subjects such as the delay in the local government elections. I must also add a few comments on behalf of my party that we have always been agitating for early elections, and it is quite apparent that this election system is replete with many inaccuracies and difficulties, and that is why we are facing these stumbling blocks. Therefore, it would be more advisable for us to revert to the earlier system. If we are unable to correct the anomalies that are there in the present system, there is absolutely enough room to revert back to the earlier system, which at least temporarily for the impending elections that we are about to face. And this is something that we must agitate, and we have been talking to the backbenchers of this government as well as many party leaders. They are quite in favor to this idea of reverting back to the earlier system if we are unable to conduct elections according to the current new electoral system. Having said that, may I take the few minutes that are available to speak on the relevant ministry votes. Now, we are discussing the votes of the Ministry of Women's and Child Affairs as well as the Ministry of Foreign Employment. Both of these ministries are being led by two able women on our side, Honorable Talata Atukorala and Honorable Chandrani Bandara, who have, in my opinion, during their period, have moved beyond the mere symbolism of improving the conditions for women in our country, but have introduced some groundbreaking new changes. The most often spoken about change is the political representation of women issue, which has now been enacted into law, and we have provided a quota for women in the local authority elections, and we will follow it up with the provincial councils and as well as to parliament as well. In this regard, we must congratulate the women's caucus in this parliament. In addition to these two lady ministers, I must also congratulate my own state minister, Honorable Dr. Sudarshini Funandupulle, for having agitated for these changes, and we are all very proud and happy that we were able to bring these changes. Now, let me speak a few words on the issue relating to female labor force participation in this country. The issue of female labor force participation is a very important issue for both our lady ministers, and this matter globally today, they say, according to the statistics, only 50% of women are working or earning in the world. Now, the statistics show that in this country, female labor force participation is much lower. It is at 35%. It is important for us to concentrate on the reasons and improve the female labor force participation. If we are to do that, we need to look at both the supply and demand side shortcomings that needs to be addressed. Particularly, now if you look at the world ratio, they say, now if female labor force participation in the United States can be brought to parity with that of men, that is, if we can increase the female labor force participation is to a level of men in the labor force participation, in the United States, their GDP can go up by 5%. Similarly, the GDP in Japan could go up by 9%. In United Arab Emirates, it could increase up to 12%. In countries like Egypt, the GDP improvement can go up by 33%, where there is much lower female labor force participation. Now, such statistics are not available when it comes to Sri Lanka, but this indicates that we need to take some important steps towards both the demand and supply side issues concerning female labour force participation. My colleague, Honourable Iran Vikramaratne, dealt with some of the workplace improvements that we can introduce in order to improve the female labour force participation, particularly flexible working hours and better workplace conditions for women. Workplace conditions is simply not the childcare facilities alone. Even simple issues like toilets, separate toilets for women in workplaces is something that we need to give more legal recognition and enforce in building requirements. Now we have in the recent past introduced legislation to provide toilet facilities for disabled people, but when it comes to female labour force, this is a very serious issue. Menstrual health improvement issues is a very serious issue. Therefore, we need to try and introduce legislation to make it compulsory for any buildings that will have public entry in those buildings to have separate toilet facilities both for females and men.
Now, Honourable Minister, you have only one more minute. One more minute.
I know, very short time. Therefore, then the dignity is another issue that women face in the reason for lack of female labour force participation is dignity factor relating to the job selection that they have. Now, we know in the apparel sector, 80% of women used to participate, but then, you know, they are, you know, when they refer to the girls who are working there, we refer to them as juki girls. You know, women didn't want to suffer this indignity, and therefore today, women labour force in the apparel sector has come down very drastically, and it has become a problem, and the apparel industry is now looking for means to provide better working conditions, and some apparel factories are even providing creche facilities for feeding mothers and others to bring to get them to come and work as machine operators in the apparel sector. And this is and therefore it is important for us to address some of these issues pertaining to improving both the demand and supply side issues. On the supply side, I know we must also look at the cultural constraints that we have, particularly transport facilities and proximity to the workplace is another issue. Women prefer to work closer home. And it is also, now today with the increasing educational facilities, women have tended to become better educated. When they are better educated, it also results in delaying their marriages, and therefore lower fertility rates also become an issue these days. Now, these are all connected, interconnected. And then aging population is another issue. Now, in countries where there is better female labor force participation, they fill the gap with where the aging population has increased and there is a lack of labor force participation generally. And if women can be better educated and they can, their choices can be widened, their dignity issues can be addressed, we could improve better female labour force participation, and that is important for us if we are to achieve our targets in Vision 2025 in doubling our per capita income, Mr. Chairman. With those comments, I conclude. Thank you.